What I am holding is a specimen of the uranium ore mineral carnotite which I collected within Arizona. While this mineral, which contains approximately 52.8% by weight uranium, is quite radioactive, the short amount of time I am holding this specimen before placing it entirely within a lead container means briefly holding this piece is not as dangerous as you might think it is. Traditionally, uranium, or element number 92, is thought to be the highest numbered element which naturally exists within Earth's crust, having an abundance of approximately 2.2 parts per million. I was even taught this fact in both geology and chemistry classes, which stated that there are only 92 elements which naturally exist in Earth's crust, with uranium being the highest numbered such element, and the rest being only made in a lab or artificial nuclear reactors. Yet, what if I were to tell you that uranium is not actually the highest numbered element to naturally exist on Earth? This prospect might seem absurd, but it is completely true. As instead, there are two higher numbered elements which exist on the planet, with the first being known as Neptunium. Neptunium, or element number 93, is also a highly radioactive silver-colored metal which has a density approximately 7% higher than uranium and naturally occurs in two isotopes. These isotopes are Neptunium-237 and Neptunium-239. Before I explain how these isotopes form, I will first elaborate how absurdly rare Neptunium is. For context, the total mass of the Earth's crust is 2.77 times 10 to the 19th power metric tons. If we take into account the abundance of gold, which is 2.9 parts per billion, and multiply it by the weight of the crust, we get 80.33 billion metric tons of gold. Yet, although there are widely varying estimates, there is believed to be only 11,080 kilograms of Neptunium in the entire crust. This means that while some does exist, naturally formed Neptunium is 7.25 billion times rarer than gold. However, unlike uranium, Neptunium did not exist in large quantities when the Earth initially formed. So, how did this element eventually form? The answer relates to a very narrow and specific reaction sequence involving two isotopes of uranium. For context, due to how unstable radioactive atoms are, half of them will decay after a set period of time in what is known as a half-life. This occurs through three main fashions, alpha, beta, and gamma decay, where beta decay involves a neutron becoming a proton in an atom, meaning an isotope increases in atomic number by one. However, there is also a very rare process called neutron capture, where a neutron can somewhat randomly combine with an atom, causing the mass number to increase by one while remaining as the same element. When counting naturally formed uranium, uranium-238 comprises 99.3% of the total uranium, while uranium-235 comprises the vast majority of the remaining 0.7%. While uranium-235 is far less common than uranium-238, the potential end product neptunium isotope is the most stable when compared to the end product possible of neptunium when you begin with uranium-238. In this reaction, rare neutron capture occurs within uranium-235, turning it into uranium-236. Before the uranium-236 decays, it then undergoes another rare neutron capture event, turning into uranium-237. Uranium-237 will then naturally decay via beta decay, resulting in the creation of Neptunium-237, which has an unusually long half-life for this high-numbered element of 2.144 million years. A similar reaction can also occur where uranium-238 undergoes a rare neutron capture event to become uranium-239. This will then naturally decay in a fairly short period of time via beta decay, resulting in Neptunium-239, which only has a half-life of 2.35 days. Yet, Neptunium is not the heaviest naturally formed element, as instead, that title will be granted to the element placed at one higher of a spot on the periodic table, plutonium. While there are numerous isotopes of artificially made plutonium, only one formed naturally, plutonium-244, which has an unusually long half-life of 80 million years. Because of this long half-life, there is still a very minute quantity of this isotope which hasn't decayed yet from the very formation of our planet. As 4.543 billion years ago, the amount of plutonium-244 in the Earth's crust was estimated to be 0.8% the original amount of uranium-238. This means the Earth's crust initially contained approximately 961.1 billion metric tons of plutonium-244. However, since the time span of approximately 57 half-lives of this isotope have passed, only an insignificant 7.728 grams of this isotope naturally exists across the entire planet's crust. Thus, plutonium is the rarest naturally formed element which exists in the Earth's crust. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.